Hello everybody and welcome to Luxury Benefits channel. My name is Sviatoslav and in this video I would like to talk about microelements zinc, copper, manganese, calcium that are needed for the eyes, trace minerals that are good for the eyes. Zinc enhances the action of various hormones, improves the formation of hemoglobin and the process of erythrocyte formation, wound healing, increases the body resistance to infections. It is essential for normal growth. Zinc affects activity of hormones and of the pituitary gland. It also increases enzyme activity. Zinc enhances intellectual abilities and memory, fights depression, stress, plays an important role in the control of epileptic seizures. Its deficiency causes cataracts, lens aging. Zinc helps the body absorb vitamin A and also helps to reduce the amount of free radicals in the body, prevents the development of retinal degeneration and inhibits the decline in light vision. The body needs for zinc 10 to 15 mg per day for adults and 4 to 6 mg for children. Sources of zinc are meat, seafood, eggs, yeast, rice, cereals and legumes. Mushroom contains the largest amount of zinc. They contain 130 to 202 mg per 1 kilo of dry substances. In onion, 100 mg. In potatoes, 11 mg. Excess zinc inhibits growth and disrupts bone mineralization. With zinc deficiency, grows overexcitation of the nervous system and quick fatigue. Skin lesions occurs with a thickening of the epidermis, skin edema, mucous membranes of the mouth, and hair loss. Zinc deficiency can lead to increased accumulation of iron, copper, cadmium. Copper is involved in tissue respiration, hemoglobin synthesis, and maturation erythrocytes. Copper is also involved in the growth and reproduction processes. Copper is powerful an antioxidant that protects the eyes from inflammatory diseases. It also supports collagen binding, ensuring vascular strength. With the lack of copper in the body, there are observed growth retardation, anemia, dermatosis, depigmentation of hair, partial baldness, loss of appetite. The body daily requirement for copper is 2 mg. Sources of copper are beef, liver, shrimps, oats, mushrooms, beans, watermelon, pepper. Excess copper leads to deficiencies in zinc, molybdenum, as well as manganese. Manganese is found in all organs and tissues. It prevents the accumulation of fat in the liver, improves the formation of hemoglobin, increases the body defenses, improves metabolism, proteins and some vitamins B1, B6, C and E. Important for reproductive function. Manganese helps improve muscle reflexes, prevent osteoporosis, improve memory and reduce nervous irritability. For the eyes, it works just like a copper. Rye, oats, legumes, beets, pumpkins, raspberries, black currants, tea, nuts, green vegetables with leaves, pears, beets are the main products which contains manganese. With the lack of manganese, ossification process are disrupted throughout the skeleton, tubular bones thicken and shortened joints are deformed. Reproductive ovarian and testicular function. Excess manganese increases magnesium and copper deficiencies. Selenium. Its role in the body is still poorly understood, but it's believed that it slows down aging. In addition, selenium helps maintain youthful tissue elasticity. It protects cells from decay products. eliminates fatigue and reduces the likelihood of tumors. It's believed to act in the same way for the eyes as copper or manganese. Daily allowances are 5 mg for women and 7 mg for men. Selenium works well with vitamin E, contained in seafood, kidneys, liver, onions, tomatoes, broccoli, cabbage. Selenium hyperdoses causes an enlargement of the liver and pain in the right hypochondrium and pain in limbs, cramps, feeling of numbness. With a deficiency of selenium in the body, arsenic and cadmium accumulate, which in turn exacerbate selenium deficiency. In this turn, selenium protects the body from heavy metals, and an excess can lead to a deficiency of calcium. Calcium is found in bones and teeth. They contain 99% of all calcium in the body, and only 1% is found in other tissues and in the blood. It regulates the permeability of cell membranes and blood coagulability, balance of excitation and inhibition process in the cortex brain. The daily requirement for calcium is 0.8 to 1 gram. The body need for calcium increases during pregnancy and lactation, bone fractures. With an excess of calcium in the body, chronic arthritis develops. The structure of bone tissue is disturbed, muscle weakness develops, coordination of movements become difficult, heart rhythm disturbances. With a lack of calcium, there are tachycardia, arrhythmia, whitening of the fingers and toes, muscle pain, vomiting, constipation, increased irritability, disorientation in space, hallucination, confusion. Hair is done rough and fall out, nails become brittle, the skin thickens and coarsens. On the enamel of the teeth pits, grooves appear, the lens of the eye loses its transparency. Calcium in food, both plants and animal, is in the form of insoluble salts. They are not absorbed in the stomach, but in the upper part of the small intestine, mainly in 12th duodenum. Their bile acids have a great influence on absorption. Therefore, in diseases of the liver or intestine, the absorption of calcium may be difficult. It seems to be a person eats calcium-containing foods or even medication, but still he doesn't have calcium enough. The largest amount of calcium is found in milk, cheese, cottage, vegetables and fruits. In the intestines are better absorbed by the calcium of dairy products. Excess calcium can lead to deficiencies in zinc and phosphorus, while at the same time inhibiting accumulation of lead in bone tissue. All pharmaceutical calcium must also contain vitamin D, since it improves the absorption of calcium and protects bone tissue from destruction. Thanks for watching this video to the end. Today we discussed how important trace elements for the eyes, such as zinc, copper, manganese and calcium, and for whole body overall. I hope it will help you. Subscribe to my channel and we'll see you again.